Dr. Sunil Kothari is a recipient of Padmashree Award and the Academy Ratna. Dr. Kothari is a noted Indian historian, scholar, critic who has over 12 books on different forms of Indian classical dance and allied art forms. And as we know that today he's here to share more about Sattriya with the film and his talk. We have requested him to share about his entire research on Sattriya and to represent the dance form. We are extremely honored. Yeah. Thank you so much, sir.
You know, it was in 1958 with Dr. Mulkaraj Anand had gone to Delhi. Think of 1958, we are in 2018. Some 60 years ago, for the first time, I was barely 21, 22, the dancers who came from the monastery of Assam. Even I didn't know where exactly Assam was. In 1950, when I was appearing for the SSC examination, I had heard about earthquake in Dibrugarh. So I told my friend Bhupen Kakkar, let's see map and find out where is Dibrugarh. That's how I found out far, far away in a corner, someplace Assam was there. I'll show in the film also where Assam is. Thanks to the Jhaveri sisters and Guru Bipin Singh, I knew where Manipur was. Manipur and they were so close to each other, but still I had not known anything about Assam. And we saw for the first time in 1958, I think it was April 3rd, at the Vigyan Bhavan in New Delhi, three, four monks came and they performed. They performed drums, they performed dance, and they're all male, playing the role of female gopis because they are all celibate monks who live in Assam. And believe me, we did not know, none of us. There was Rukmini Devi Arundel, there was Bala Saraswati, there was Shambhu Maharaj, Lachu Maharaj, Birju Maharaj. You name them and they were all there, Dr. V. Raghavan. Nobody knew in Assam. For 500 years, this dance was practiced in the monastery by the monks. A sheer devotion. There was no other intention except to pray to the God and for his entertainment, not for their own entertainment. And this was something I was ushered into a new world. So Mulk uncle said, "Can you take a train?" In 1958, he said, "You better go after some time. For your field work, I'll give you some 300-400 rupees. Find out where is, how to go to by train to Calcutta, to Farakka Bridge to go to Guwahati, from Guwahati go to Jorhat, from Jorhat, as you'll see in the film, Jorhat you go to Nimai Ghat, from Nimai Ghat go by launch to the Brahmaputra River, and on the other end of Brahmaputra River, you'll find Majuli Island, and that's not enough. After going to Majuli Island, you have to walk 3 miles on foot and go there. Put your chappal outside and you enter into the monastery. It's an entirely different world. You are going to see that. I saw for the first time the great gurus. You don't go and show your back to the guru. You do pranam to the guru. Sit down over there. They are Vaishnavas. So you take head bath. They give you food like that. You cannot touch them. If you touch them, you take bath again, as you'll see in the film also. And this was an entirely new world. The drums were being played. There are huge, large cymbals were being played. They can resonate in your ear from long ago. And vast areas of the, you know, monastery. There are 4 rows of the houses and they are found old monk who is 101 year old who becomes the head of the department. And small little kutti children will be sent to learn under them the Vedas, the Puranas, scriptures, Sanskrit and also dance. It was a new world entirely. I knew some Bharatanatyam, I knew hand gestures, I could speak in English language here and there. So with one guru, Ghanakant Bora, I was introduced to the world of dance. As we know, we have the Shavatar, but there were also Chaturvinshati Avatar, 24 Avatar of Srimad Bhagavata. I didn't know all these things. There were hand gestures, there were dance dramas, there were huge mass of Bakasur. You know the story of Bakasur that he opened and then when I saw, it was 30 feet tall. They opened their beak and there enter the children. And from the other side, they come out. And there was another big 30 feet long Kaliyanag. And on the hood of the Kaliyanag, little Krishna would dance. Now, this was another world. There were painters, there were masks. And all the monks were dressed in spotless white costumes. And they'll get up in the morning. They do their Sandhya Vandanam, the puja, singing. And this drumming was so different from other drumming. The other drums are very different of what you saw just now, whatever Rajan played. The Manipuri drums are different and the Assamese drums are different. But none of them knew each other very well. What I did when I was there in ashram, I met one French lady. Later on, met her in Paris. She said, but Sunil, you have been there. You helped me a lot. I had forgotten about it. What did I help her? But I must have helped her about how to photograph, what drama sequence to be taken, what is Ram Vijay Natak, what is Pimpali Kuchhua Natak, what is the Shautar. And this don't speak Sattriya. You know, in Suratma, Hurti bole ne? Hurti. So, Sa becomes her. So, Sattriya becomes always Hatriya. They never say Sattriya, Hatriya. And then, in that dance form was a combined dance form. There are 17, 18, 20 monks will come with the drum, what you saw one single boy. They play in various forms called Gayan Bayan. In the morning, it is being played Gayan Bayan. In the evening, the dance drums take place. And as you begin in the film, there are young monks who take the female role also. Now, this world was not a world that was known. I'm talking of 1964. When I first time went in 1964, as the way this girl goes there, etc., it was a different world. Even today, when I come to think of Sattriya dance, Hatriya dance they call, very few know about it. The only dancer in Bombay is one Pratisha Suresh. She's gone today to Chennai for Bharatnatyam conference. And there are not many who have taken to this dance form. It's an extremely beautiful form. But even then, non-Assamese have not taken to Sattriya. Often I raise this question, which I'll talk about in the end. What I want you to see, that how does one, a foreigner, who has great interest about Indian dance, and with the completely innocent eyes, without any prejudices, this lady comes to the ashram. Formerly, they did not allow the women to enter into the ashram. But this great guru, Satradhikar Janardhan Goswami, was generous. He said, they should come, let them study about etc. And they will stay in their separate compartment and department. But let them understand what is the story of this satra. There are huge namgar. The prayer hall is so big that you only see the sound of these symbols which ring in your ears. And they come for the prayer. Now, when they teach the young children, they do mati akhada, the physical exercises. And little boys, and the guru plays the drum. One of the finest drummers is Ghanakant Bora, and one is called Bhavanan, Burban. Burban, one who plays drum and who can sing, etc. I straight want to start the film. I want you to know how tough it is to go to Assam. And it was tougher for me. In those days, I didn't know even except Bengali. I didn't know much of the language, how to speak, etc. But people were kind. Finest thing about India, even today I feel, it's so marvelous to be in India. People will help you. They'll bring for you suffragan, they'll bring for you water, they'll guide you gently to the place when they come to know that you have come to do research work about them. Let's start. Now this is the Namghar. That is how you enter to the Satra and they perform over there. So we begin with the dance of Krishna performed by Niranjan Goswami. He's one of the young monks and he trains the other young men. He becomes like a father and mother to a child whom he brings it up. And when the beautiful sequences are shown how the child treats him like mother and father both. So when I saw one sequence of a young boy who is brought to the ashram and he says that I was left as an orphan to the entrance of the satra, my mother had gone to collect rice and she drowned. And I was born of unwed mother marriage. And I was left in this. And when I came here, I began to cry a lot. My father had also gone away. My mother had gone away. And I came to an ashram where only these monks were there. And one of the monks took me under his wings and began to train me up. Should I sound aya? These are normal things. The glitches about, you know, technology. Social media. Instagram. Emmanuel Petit, Emmanuel had done interviews where we have got subtitles because they speak all in Ahamya. So we said, let us have the subtitles. And the subtitles are heartbreaking when you come to know that unknown, unwanted children are brought and they become great pandits, they become great scholars. They are also the great teachers. They are the great gurus who teach Sattriya dance. And it was sometime in 2015, November, it was given the status as a classical dance form. I started working on Sattriya from the year 1964, and often in this very theater, here, a very place, I had brought Indira P.P. Bora and her daughter Menaka P.P. Bora, and the great guru, Rasivshar Saikya, and another great guru, Ghanakant Bora, to perform here. I repeated it every year alternate year. And then I took this artist also to Chennai, to Calcutta, to New Delhi, and Ahmedabad. And we wanted to form this one. Thank you. Similarly, when I stayed there,
there are places which attract you to them like magnets and draw you in through mysterious connections. I'm on a bumpy road in Assam in northeast India. With a bit of luck, I'll soon be with the monks of Majuli.
This is how when you travel to Assam, look at the greenery and the natural beauty. The same even now.
New Delhi, Guwahati, Jorhat. Several days hard travel across sky, earth and water to get to Assam. A forgotten corner of the planet that's my little world.
Now see where Assam is.
Assam means unequaled. It's a region that's always been wild and mysterious, and whose dire practices of sorcery discouraged invaders.
You can hear the sound
in these lands, the supernatural world coexists with the world of the living. In the 15th century, to put an end to these uncivilized practices, the great visionary master Sri Sri Sankaradeva started a religious tradition unique in Hinduism, based around monasteries called Satra. The Satra are cultural centers whose philosophy of life assigns an important role to the performing arts. Thousands of men have become monks, but monks of a unique kind. Today I'm going to meet them. It's difficult to get to the island, which is probably why its original tribal populations haven't been dislodged.
Insurgency, you can see the soldiers there.
Northeast India used to be a backwater cut off from the world. Now it's developing economically at a great rate, but still suffers from frequent terrorist activities.
Terrorist activity. Look at the vast canvas of the river. You go by steam launch, same way.
Surrounded by all this turmoil, the island of Majuli sits peacefully in the middle of the fabled river Brahmaputra. Born from the waters with its 800 square kilometers of sands and alluvium, forests and marshes, the immense river island of Majuli is almost completely unknown in the West, as are the Satra, its unusual monasteries.
Now the buses fly up to the monastery. But this is how the mist in the morning. Unbelievably, it's a beautiful plot. It's a heritage site now.
All roads on the island lead to a monastery. When the asphalt stops, there's usually a track. And after the track, a little path. 8 years ago, when I discovered the Uttakamalabari Sattra, very few Westerners had come this way.
No Westerners were allowed at that time.
The Hindu monks let me in when I had nowhere to sleep or eat. Even though I was a woman, a foreigner, coming from a Christian tradition.
Jagardhan Goswami.
Amarta Hongkor Gurujan or Ador Hogoto, the Nyom, but the Himote, I mean Hokoluke, the Hibi, the Hi Hokoluke, I mean Manasagotom Zanato, Amar Porombragot of Ape Solia is.
They allowed the woman to come and stay there. Very sure they didn't. Now, these are the houses, in one of the houses I stayed. They're all
like. Today, the Bakats call me the daughter of the monasteries.
She was called daughter of the monastery.
Of living directly with them. Sri Sri Janadan Dev Goswami is the Satradika. He's responsible for the running of the monastery. He's the one that makes all the important decisions. However, his decisions are submitted to a council representing all the monks, and he doesn't have the right of veto. Each house is a community of 3 to 6 monks of 3 different generations.
3 generations.
Usually the eldest, the old sage, has authority over the others.
They have been trained by Niranjan.
Children are adopted around the age of 5, sometimes earlier. When the eldest member of the group dies, his authority passes tacitly to the next oldest.
আমি বুঢ়াভকত হিসাবে আছোঁ আমাৰ ওপৰত বুঢ়াভকত আছিলে তেখেত ঢুকাল ঢুকোৱাৰ পিছত আমি বুঢ়াভকত হৈছোঁ বুঢ়াভকতৰ আমি ইফালে ইফালে গ'লে আৰু আমাৰ পিছত সৰু হেৰি মহিকান্ত বৰা আছে আমাৰ 6 আছোঁ আমাৰ বহাখনত 6 আছোঁ
ঘৰৰ বিষয়ে আমাৰ বহাত 3 থাকে তাৰপৰা বুঢ়াভকত আছে দাদা আছে আৰু মই আছোঁ তেখেতসকলৰ বিষয়ে মানে আমাৰ গোটেই বহা দায়িত্বখিনি তেখেতে চলায় মোৰ পঢ়া মেলাৰ পৰা ধৰি লৈ সকলোখিনি তেখেতে চলায় কাপোৰ কানিৰ পৰা ধৰি মেলি যিমানখিনি
লাগে ক্লোথিং লজিং বৰ্ডিং চ' ইচ হাউচ হেজ 3 or 6 পিপল
When he first came to the Sattra, Niranjan was no taller than the little boy he's taking care of today.
তাৰপৰা এনে চালো তাৰপৰা মা দেউতাহঁত মানে মই খুব ঘৰলৈ মনত পৰে খুব মই কান্দো
আটাইতকৈ
মই বেছিকৈ কান্দো নেকি ঘৰলৈ যাব সেইকাৰণে ইচ্ছা কৰোঁ মানে তাৰপৰা মানে কি হয় মাও আহে দেউতাও আহে মায়ে কি কৰে ভিতৰতে থাকোঁ নহয় থাকোঁতেনে আৰু এতিয়া মা যোৱা গম পাম নহয় মই খুব কান্দো মা গৈ পেলাই অলপ দূৰ ৰৈ থাকিবগৈ মই গুচি আহিম বুলি দেউতা ক'ব অলপ হেৰি আছিলে দেউতা ৰৈ থাকিব ৰৈ থাকিব ৰৈ থাকিব মানে খুব কান্দো কাৰণ মোক চবেই ধৰি ৰাখি মোক দুৱা মাৰি ৰাখি থৈ দিয়ে ভিতৰত মা গৈ ঘৰ পাইগৈ মই কান্দি 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 তাতে বিচনাতে শুংগো আৰু বহুত দিনলৈকে মানে মোৰ ঘৰৰ প্ৰতি মানে খুব হেৰি আছিলে মা দেউতালৈ তাক খুব মনত পৰিছিলে কিন্তু এতিয়া আৰু এটা মস্তৰ পালোহি যেতিয়া মোৰ ইমান হেৰি নালাগে আৰু ইয়াতে ভাল লাগে বেছিভাগ থাকি
তাৰমানে আমাৰ মায়ে প্ৰথম এজনে মাক ধৰি আনিছিলে বিয়া কৰা নাছিলে ধৰি আনিছিলে আনি মই জন্ম হ'লোঁ হোৱাৰ পিছতে মাৰ আৰু দেউতাৰ মাজত মানে বিভাদ ঘটিলে বিভাজন ঘটাত মায়ে মানে অলপ আমাৰ কি কৰিম কি নকৰিম বুলি মোক লৈ ফুৰিছে থৈ পেলাই আমাৰ মামা এজন আছে মিহিকান্ত যে তেখেতৰ মাকে বোলে তই ল'ৰাটো এনেকৈ লৈ ফুৰাতকৈ তই সত্ৰতে থৈ থাকে জানাই বুলি ক'লে তাৰপৰা মায়ে আনি পেলাই ইয়াত আৰু সত্ৰতে বিচাৰি এইখন বহাতে থ'লে মোক থোৱাৰ পিছত মা অন্য এজনলৈ বিয়া হৈ গুচি গ'ল মোক সেই ঢুকোৱা বুঢ়া ভকতে সেইজনে ইজন 105 বছৰ যেন ঢুকালে তেখেতে মোক গৰু গাখীৰৰ লগত অলপ পানী মিহলাই মিহলাই খুৱায় কাৰণ গাখীৰ খুৱালে পেটত ধৰিব যে গাখীৰৰ লগত পানী মিহলাই মিহলাই নিচুকাই নিচুকাই বুকত বান্ধি বান্ধি লৈ ফুৰিছিলে তেনেকৈ ভাল মানে মা নিজৰ মাকেও সেইটো প্ৰতিপাল কৰিব নোৱাৰে বুঢ়া ভকতে যিটো প্ৰতিপাল কৰিলে কৰি তোলালে বুঢ়াভকতৰ মানে গাখীৰটোকে মই খাওঁ, বুঢ়াভকতৰ যিটো গাখীৰ আছিলে সেইটোকে মই যেনিবা খাওঁ আৰু। তেতিয়া এনেই নিচুকা আৰু, কিন্তু গৰু গাখীৰহে খুৱাইছিলে সেইটো। বুঢ়াভকতৰ মতা মানুহটোকো গাখীৰ ওলাব।
When I first met Upen, he hardly spoke. Now he's full of self-assurance, a solid tutor for the family for which he's responsible. The Bakats don't live off charity. They work to support not only themselves, but their adoptive children, and the old and sick members of the community. They live mainly from the cultivation of rice, their staple food. They share the work in their fields next to the Sattriya with hired workers from the village. Most of the monks are peasants. A few are merchants or teachers. Only a tiny minority have been able to benefit from further education and find better paid jobs. But above all, they're performers.
The prayers, the juxtaposition.
One of the fine players. Very different drum playing than the Manipuri drum. It's known as Gayak band. Using various hand gestures also.
Sri Babananda Babayan is the director of the monastery company. I've always been struck by his exemplary humility. Even though he's the first Bhagat to have pursued advanced studies in India's universities.
He's PhD from RG University, Ravindra Bhari.
A performer and director of renown, he's just completing a doctorate on the Sattriya tradition.
মই 4 বছৰ বয়সৰ পৰা নৃত্য শিক্ষা গ্ৰহণ কৰিছো, যেতিয়া মই সত্ৰলৈ আনে সৰুতে তেতিয়াৰ পৰা। আৰু মই 17 বছৰ বয়সত মই সত্ৰৰে যেটো বৰবায়নৰ নিৰ্মালী বুলি কয়, যেটো এজন ভাল পটু শিল্পী হিচাপে মোক স্বীকৃতি দিয়ে। আৰু তাৰপিছতে মই যিটো পৰিৱেশন কৰিবৰ কাৰণে আগবাঢ়িলোঁ আৰু বিভিন্ন স্থানত শংকৰদেৱৰ তেখেতৰ জন্ম 1516 শতিকাত। গতিকে তেখেত জন্ম হয় অসমৰ যিটো সাংস্কৃতিক পৰিৱেশ আৰু ভাৰতীয় যিটো প্ৰেক্ষাপটৰ যিটো সাংস্কৃতিক পৰিৱেশ, এইসমূহক অধ্যয়ন কৰি তেখেতে এটা নৃত্য সৃষ্টি কৰিছিল। সেই নৃত্যটোৱে হ'ল সত্ৰীয়া নৃত্য। গতিকে ইয়াৰ বয়স এতিয়াও 500 বছৰৰ ওপৰৰ। যিটো নেও বৈষ্ণৱিজিম বুলি কয়, সেই সংশোধিত ৰূপ এটাত তেওঁ ধৰ্ম প্ৰচাৰ কৰিবলৈ ল'লে কৃষ্ণকেন্দ্ৰ কৰি। গতিকে তেতিয়াই তেওঁ অসমত কৃষ্ণকেন্দ্ৰিক এটা জাগৰণ সৃষ্টি কৰিলে আৰু সেই প্ৰচাৰ কৰিবৰ কাৰণে তেখেতে মাধ্যম হিচাপে লৈছিল অংকীয়া ভাওনা আৰু সত্ৰীয়া নৃত্য।
Far away from the civilization.
You can go in and out of the Sattriya without difficulty. It's not walled in. There's just a door to show you where you should take off your shoes. The tradition of removing one's shoes is not only out of respect for these sacred places, but also for the pleasure of making subtle contact with the earth.
Contact with the earth, that's why you walk. Now we don't know how milk is being drawn this way. So don't touch the 27th as well.
At certain times of the day, everyone knows that they mustn't touch the monks directly or even through an object. Before engaging in sacred activities like eating or praying, the monks know they have to be absolutely pure. Taken the purifying bath, they have to wash all over again, hair and clothes included. It doesn't much matter if that makes them late for something else, and the water's cold.
Prayers in the Namghar congregation hall. There are no idols.
The monks in the Gurudwara take no.
They put next, go to the next. And like in Gurudwara, they put the sacred Granth Sahib. So also in Satra, the Srimad Bhagavat, the manuscript is put on the Manikut, on the big Sinhasan, etc. And we find that that was perhaps during the 15th century and 50 years later on. Guru Nanak, Sankardev, many of the great saints, they were looking for one religion. And they say Sankardev brought great uniformity by dispensing with various idols and what they called is Neo-Vaishnavism. Next one, laga dena. The next one.
And are free to leave at any time. The prayers are not very long, but they're always sincere. There's no religious extravagance, just some scriptures, a few centuries old. Most of all, it's a philosophy of life, whose key element is love. If this movement is relatively unknown, it's partly because there's no proselytization. In fact, no one here has ever tried to tell me about it. And whenever I wanted to raise the subject myself, I had to ask question after question.
Yes, heaven is please. Only one, and God is also only one. Mm. But the way is different to go there.
Oh, okay.
So okay. I should respect all religion according to their activities. I don't try to provide that you should become a good monk of our monastery or our religion. We have special activities of the religion. So according to our that schedule, we should have to do, we should have to follow the things.
Mm.
And I don't try to provide that you should also do so.
There's no compulsion that you follow in particular manner.
Now,
this is the most touching aspect of how the brought up
Kandi,
there is a sense when he came, he was being trained like that. So he trained this
child. নিশ্চয় সেইটো হেঁপাহ তাৰ প্ৰতি থকাৰ কাৰণে আৰু সেইটো হেঁপাহ কাৰণ নাথাকিলেতো ল'ৰা এটা লোকৰ ল'ৰা এটা আনি পুহিব নোৱাৰোঁ সেইটো এতিয়া মোক পোৱাৰ বা আমাৰখন বহাৰ পৰা এইটো মাক বাপেকক পাহৰি গৈছে সেইটো ল'ৰাই কাৰণ আমি তাক দেখিব নোৱাৰা হ'লে মৰম নকৰা হ'লেতো সি মাক বাপেকলৈ সদায় মনত পৰিলেহেঁতেন তাৰ মাক আহি এতিয়া সেইটো ল'ৰাও মাক আহিলেতো সিটো মতা নাই
because mother and father to him.
I remember being shocked to see these little monks deprived of their mother so young. Since then, I've seen how these men raise their children, sometimes like real mothers.
আচলতে বহাৰ যিজন মোৰ সৰু ভাইটি তেওঁৰ দেউতাক নাই মাক যেতিয়া আছিল মাকৰ গৰ্ভতে তেওঁ দেউতাক ঢুকালে এক্সিডেণ্ট হয় তেওঁ ল'ৰাজনৰ মানে খুচৰাই নাইকিয়া মানে মাকৰ কোলাতে থকা মাকে কাম কৰিবলৈ যাব লাগে ল'ৰাজন মানে এতিয়া কি কৰিব পেটৰ পোহৰ কাৰণে তেতিয়া মানে তাত ওচৰতে মানে দফলা আছে আৰু ময়ো তেওঁক খুৱাই মেলি দিওঁ এতিয়ালৈকে তেওঁ নিজৰ মানে ভাইটি নিচিনাকেই যেতিয়া মাক দেউতাক নাই আৰু মাক দেউতাকৰ নিচিনাকেই তেওঁক মই ৰাখিছোঁ এতিয়ালৈকে আৰু তেওঁৰ খুব ভাল লাগে দুষ্ট যদিও মানে কি আৰু এনেকৈয়ে ভাল লাগে আৰু
This is how the training is given from the childhood to the children. A physical exercise called Mati Akhada. Govanand is training them. The bodies become very pliable when they take this training. And 64 practices are Mati Akhada.
তাতকৈ বেছি বয়স হ'লে গঠন গাৰ গঠন মোটা হ'ব তেওঁক সেইটো শিক্ষা দিব পৰা নাযাব সেইটো ধৰ্মলৈ হয়তো তেওঁক আনিবলৈ সুবিধা হ'ব সেইটো কাৰণে সেই সুবিধাটোৰ কাৰণে তিনি বছৰৰ পৰা পাঁচ বছৰৰ ভিতৰত যদি সত্ৰলৈ আনিব পৰা যায়
সেইটো
দেখাত সেইটোতো মানে তাত 90% প্লাছ পইণ্ট আছে যদি ল'ৰাটো দেখিবলৈ সুন্দৰ হয় তেতিয়াহ'লে আমাৰ নাচ নৃত্য সকলো বিষয়ত মানে তেওঁৰ কাৰণে এটা ভাল প্ৰভিজন থাকে মানে ভাল সুবিধা এটা থাকে যে তেওঁক
আমাৰ সত্ৰত বিশেষকৈ আমাৰ নৃত্য শিক্ষা দিয়াৰ কিছুমান নীতি আছে ইয়াৰ ভিতৰত হ'ল আমাৰ খুব পুৱাতে খুব কমেও দিনটোত আমি 4.5 ঘণ্টা আমাৰ অনুশীলন
এভৰি মৰ্ণিং Different bowls.
মোৰ 8 বছৰ থাকোঁতেই 10 বছৰমান থাকোঁতেই মা ঢুকাল ডাউন দ্য ৱাটাৰ মানে হেৰি ৰাইজ কাটি আছিলে মানে তাৰপৰা ব্ৰহ্মপুত্ৰ কাষেদি আছিলে মানে নৈ এটা আছিলে তাত মানে পুৰি মা ঢুকালে মানে
মা
9 বছৰমান হৈছে মানে সত্ৰীয়া যিখিনি কালচাৰ আছে মানে সেইখিনি মানে শিকিবৰ কাৰণে মানে শিকিবৰ কাৰণে হেৰিয়ৰ পৰা বুঢ়াভকতে যিজন দণ্ডিৰাম স্বৰ্গীয় দণ্ডিৰাম বুঢ়াভকত বুলি কয় তেখেতে মানে সত্ৰলৈ আনিছিলে তেখেতে কৰি মানে নিজেই লালন পচন কৰি মানে ডাঙৰ দীঘল কৰিছে আৰু মোৰ ধৰি লওক মোৰ 12 বছৰমান থাকোঁতে তেখেতে ঢুকাল মই 7 বছৰ অকলে মানে অকলে আছোঁ
They read the newspaper in the morning, not that they are cut off completely.
At the beginning of the 3rd millennium, the monks of Assam live in dwellings that have hardly changed since the Middle Ages. The only innovations in their lives are toothpaste, the newspapers, electricity when it works, and now a few mobile phones, and just recently the old scooter or TV.
take me, they take tea like that, they give it to you in a cup.
The buildings of these satras are not particularly attractive or impressive.
There's also mobile there.
You need to spend time within these walls to feel the way the legends which inhabit them give them a strangely mysterious resonance.
The Bhargit, the songs written by Madhav Dev and Shankar sung. That's what contemporary life.
Hello?
They are preparing for Ras Lila. This is a girl who puts on the falsies. Bra.
Raised to the rank of classical Indian dance since 2002, the Sattriya style is a codified dance which symbolizes the actions of Krishna. The dancer becomes an instrument to be played by the deity, and even sees himself as one with the deity. For the feminine roles, the monks transform themselves into perfect women.
Krishna is only male, and the rest devotees are all his female devotees, gopis.
So don't be fooled. These seductive gopis dallying with the flute-playing god are all men.
Read the taal, specific taal, as Darshana explained. Also hand gestures. Proud that Krishna belongs to them, then he disappears and they all repent and pray to Krishna that he should come again.
Asalte mohila role to koribole jantne okhubidha ahi pore karon ejon purushe ejon mohilar eta bhau koribole jantne choritro dekhabole jantne alop kosto ase karon apunar voice r kotha ahi pore voice tur ejon purushor jitu voice mohila dekhabole jantne man kosto anubhav hoy kintu সেইটো আমি ইমান অনুভৱ নকৰোঁ কাৰণ আমি সৰুৰ পৰা সত্ৰত শিকি যোৱা কাৰণ কৰিবলৈ যাওঁতেনে অলপ কষ্ট কৰিব লাগিব কাৰণ আনক কিবা এটা ভালকৈ দেখাবৰ কাৰণে আচলতে সিমান মোৰ মতে ইমান কষ্ট মোৰ হেত নহয়
আমাৰ কৃষ্ণ আৰু গোপীসকলৰ মাজত সেই আদান প্ৰদানটো সম্পৃক্তি ভাব সেইটো হয়তো ৰসটো বিভিন্ন ধৰণৰ ৰস হ'ব পাৰে, কিছুমানে সেই ৰসটো শৃংগাৰলৈ নিছে। কিন্তু যেতিয়া কৃষ্ণই ভাবিলে যে তেখেতসকলক অহংকাৰ হৈছে, আচলতে এইটো ভাব হ'লেতো নহ'ব, গতিকে তেওঁ এগৰাকী গোপীক অন্তৰ্ধান কৰি লৈ গুচি গ'ল। যোৱাৰ পিছত তেখেতসকলে ভাবিলে, গোপীসকলে, যে আচলতে কৃষ্ণক আমি সাধাৰণ মানৱ হিচাপে ভাবি পেলাই আমি সেই ভাৱেৰে লৈছিলোঁ, গতিকে আচলতে তেওঁক আমি তেনেধৰণে বশ্য কৰিব নোৱাৰোঁ, গতিকে আমি তেওঁক ভক্তিভাৱেৰে পূজিব লগা হ'ল। সেইকাৰণে তেওঁ তেখেতসকলে ভক্তিভাৱে পূজিবলৈ ল'লে, লোৱাৰ পিছত কৃষ্ণ আকৌ আহিল। গতিকে সেইটো তেওঁলোকৰ যিটো আন্তৰিক মিলন, ইজনে সিজনক বুজি পোৱা, সেই ভালপোৱাটোৰ লগত নহয়, তেওঁলোকৰ ভালপোৱাটোক এটা আন্তৰিক ভালপোৱা, সি হ'ল আন্তৰিক মিলন। গতিকে আমাৰ ভাৰতীয় দৰ্শনত এইটো এটা ডাঙৰ কথা যে আন্তৰিক মিলন, যে ইজনে সিজনক যদি বুজি নাপাওঁ তেতিয়াহ'লে আমি কোনো কথাতেই আমি মানে কৃতকাৰ্য হ'ব নোৱাৰোঁ।
In Majuli, the Satra live in harmony with the neighboring villages, whether Hindu or animist.
They live in harmony with the neighboring
monks
villages.
Come and go freely.
They go to college also.
Some of them study or work in different villages in the neighborhood. Some even go far away for long periods.
এটো আমি ছাত্র ছাত্রী, আমাৰ এটা ক্লাস তেতে ধৰক 20 জন ছাত্র ছাত্রী আছো, 20 জনৰে 12 জনী ছোৱালী। বিছজনী ছোৱালী থকা ছোৱালী আমাৰ লগত পঢ়ি আছে আৰু ল'ৰা আঠটা ল'ৰাৰ মাজত আমি একেলগে পঢ়া শুনা কৰি আছোঁ।
অঁ, আমাৰ অকল ভকতৰাই নহয়, মানে গোটেই মাজুলী ল'ৰা ছোৱালী আহে পঢ়িবলৈ, তাত ল'ৰা ছোৱালী চব থাকে, আমি তাৰ লগত আমি দি থাকোঁ। নাই, যিহেতুকে তেওঁলোকে জানে মানে সত্ৰ গোটেই পৰিৱেশ, মাজুলী ল'ৰা ছোৱালী থাকে, তেওঁলোকে জানে আৰু আমি সেই তেনেকুৱা তেওঁলোকৰ লগত নকৰোঁ মদ খোৱাওঁ। তেওঁলোকেও আমাক সেইটো মানে ইচ্ছা নকৰে, তেওঁলোকে পৰা আমি এক্সট্ৰা হৈ অলপ সেউ বিষয়ত থাকোঁ।
Although they mix with the other pupils at school, Jadob and Babu must always remember that they're monks. No question of going techno dancing, sharing a meal, or even going out for a cup of tea with the others.
Next one. It is interesting that the satras have now opened up for them to study. One of them did the PhD also, and Bhavananda went to Paris to train French people in the Sattriya, to the point that he came back to ashram.
Chediki course asa India university pa degree university mane pohibola to economics man nai tarabio মোৰ এই ফেভাৰিট মানে মেজৰ বিষয়টো হৈছে হিষ্ট্ৰি, মই ৱৰ্ল্ড হিষ্ট্ৰি, ইউৰোপীয়ান হিষ্ট্ৰি, এইটো ৱৰ্ল্ড ৱাৰ এইবিলাক ৰিচাৰ্চ কৰিছোঁ মানে। এতিয়া যিখিনি সুবিধা আছিলে মানে মোৰ কলেজ ফিজ আৰু মেট্ৰিক পৰীক্ষা দিবলৈ পইচা নাছিলে, তেনেকুৱা এটা অৱস্থা আহিছিলে, কিতাপ চিতাপ কিনিবলৈতো পইচা নাছিলে।
Perhaps one day he'll be able to offer a little boy the carefree existence that destiny stole from him and no longer be alone.
He goes and teaches in a school.
Maybe his father could fix it. So he took the bag to his father. The mistake of not getting a receipt. 170. Shopkeeper, visit us again.
Shopkeeper,
visit us again. Bye. And last it also, say bye. এতিয়া আমি গোট খাই পেলাই আমাৰ আচলতে আমি যথেষ্ট কষ্ট কৰোঁ। আমি মানে সাংস্কৃতিক দিশটোৰ পৰা আমি যেনেকৈ কষ্ট কৰোঁ, ঠিক আমি পথাৰ পুথুৰু আমাৰ ঘৰুৱা যিখিনি সৰ্বসাধাৰণ কাম সেইখিনিতো আমি যথেষ্ট তেনেকৈ কষ্ট কৰোঁ। গতিকে আমাৰ নিজৰ উপাৰ্জনটো আমি নিজেই উপাৰ্জন কৰোঁ, আমি কাৰো ওপৰত মানে নিৰ্ভৰ নকৰোঁ। এইটো আমাৰ এটা কথা আছে যে আমি চলি থাকিব পাৰিলে হ'লে আনক হাত নপতাগৈ, আনক নিবিচাৰাগৈ।
Market also.
আপোনাৰ যিখিনি পৰিৱেশ সেইখিনি বুজিবৰ কাৰণে মই সেইটো এটা অলপ জ্ঞান উপলব্ধ হ'ম বুলিও ভাবিলোঁ। মই সেই কামখিনি মই কৰি গৈছোঁ কি মানে বাতৰি কাকতৰ দোকান খুলিছোঁ, সেই দোকানখন খুলি পেলাই মই পইচা পাতি কিবা ইনকামৰ ব্যৱস্থা এটা কৰিছোঁ আৰু নিজে নিজক ব্যস্ত কৰি ৰাখিবৰ কাৰণে এটা ব্যৱস্থা কৰিছোঁ।
I'd like to tell you what they wouldn't tell you, because they never complain. Tirtha, Upen, Niranjan and their brothers have suffered from hunger. Even if their means are still extremely limited, that period seems to be over now. On top of their daily work, the monks prepare for their next public performances. They create the costumes and scenery themselves. Then they have to take care of the technical side of the performance at the same time as acting in it.
I'm not interested in the Jatra of Bengal in all costumes. November
উত্তম উপায় দিলাব খুদে ধন্য তুমি ময়ো ধন্য খুদে যোৱাটো চিন্তাত তেজি নিজ
Things have changed a lot now, but during the month of September, November, they play this Ras Leela and dance performances. The question is now when the rains come and the land is taken away, also people who are missing community, who are staying there. So juxtaposition of the missing community and the Satra, and what the government will do for the Satra anymore. They ask about their personal lives.
I was moved by the beauty which flowed from these young people with their relaxed and radiant features.
The Western
people. It must be their inner radiance that makes them beautiful on the outside and arouses such warmth.
Hmm.
Here, friends, whether monks or not, like to lie down side by side, to sleep or just relax. When one has nothing to give, allowing someone to come close is like a favor that one bestows, or a sign of appreciation for that person. The closeness of their relations has a disarming simplicity, which disconcerts our Western cultural notions. And we might be asking questions about their sexuality.
About the sexuality.
The monks practice sexual abstinence and aspire to be the lover of no one but Krishna.
Swami kuna bola ji patni teo he swami bili koy odike ami patni hobole hole teo bhakti adai koybo paru e she bhakti adai koybo karane ami ei prakriti rup dharan koybo karane e suli digal ke rakhibo lage suli digal ke rakha etu niyom teo bhakti adai koybo paru
In the exuberance of the gestures of those magnificent bodies, inspired by the joy of the moment, there's nothing calculated to provoke physical excitement. Those caresses are simply the most natural and pure expression of a real tenderness and the primitive pleasure of touch. They also give an intimation of another dimension of desire and love. The richness of the silence allows you to hear what the stream of words deforms. In India, not doing has as much value as doing. Those moments when the conversation stops used to embarrass me, and I felt guilty for having nothing to say. Now they have become a pleasure, the pleasure of observing everything that you don't see when you're doing something else.
Wonderful song. They play the flute.
তেখেত সকলৰ লগত আমাৰ যোগাযোগটো সম্পূৰ্ণ থাকে কাৰণ নিজা পিতৃ মাতৃৰ ওচৰলৈ আমি বছৰেকত এবাৰ যাওঁ বিহু মাইনেও কেতিয়াবা ধৰক তেওঁলোকৰ উৎসৱ বা কিবা চাবলগীয়া মন থাকিলে ধৰক তেখেতসকলো আহে আৰু আমিও যাওঁ সেইটো সম্বন্ধটো আমাৰ থাকে
The annual festival of Raslila is a chance for the families to see their children. This year, Satya's mother has come. I'm so happy for him that she's there. Her visits are so rare. The last one was 2 years ago.
আৰু আমাৰ যিটো যিখন বহা ল'ৰাটো আছে এই ল'ৰাটোৰ মাক বাপেক আজি অহা আহিম বুলি কৈছে তাৰমানে তেওঁ মানে হেৰি লৈছে গোঁসাই এপাৰ লৈছে আৰু ল'ৰাটো কেনেধৰণে তাৰমানে আমি ৰাখিছোঁ সেইখিনি চাবলৈ আহিব মানে তাৰমানে ল'ৰাটোৱে কষ্ট পাইছে নেকি বা হেৰি পাইছে নেকি সেইখিনি মানে চাবলৈ আহে
Krishna eating dust.
Upin's mother has started a new life with an understanding man who accepts that she renews contact with her son. After all these long years of separation, each visit tastes of happiness. She can enjoy to the full the attentions with which he loves to shower her, and appreciate the extent to which he has become a respected monk and accomplished performer.
Accepting the gratitude. In a legend thousands of years old, Krishna predicted that Majuli would one day become a celebrated mystic paradise.
Krishna had predicted it would become a paradise.
How could one have imagined that this little paradise would one day risk being swallowed by the waters? When I came to this spot last year, the Brahmaputra didn't pass by here. So a new branch has just been created. Major erosion and frequent floods are gradually destroying the island. Moving sandbanks constantly change its configuration, throwing up virgin territory at the expense of the inhabited zones.
সর্বসাধারণতে খুব জুলাই মাহত আর জুলাই শেষলে ইয়াত বানপানী হয়। কিন্তু এবাৰ আমাৰ মৌসুমীটো খুব মৌসুম বেদেৰিকে হোৱাৰ কাৰণে আমাৰ মাজুলীৰ মধ্য মাজুলীৰ গোটেই সম্পূৰ্ণ চাৰিও অংশত চাৰিও কিনাৰতে ব্ৰহ্মপুত্ৰ এইফালে ব্ৰহ্মপুত্ৰ আমাৰ দক্ষিণে হ'ল ব্ৰহ্মপুত্ৰ আৰু মাজুলীৰ উত্তৰে হ'ল লুই। এই দুইখন নদী অতি সম্পূৰ্ণভাৱে ওপৰলৈ মানে ফেনে ফুটকাৰে বাঢ়ি আহিলে।
2007 big floods here there.
বান্ধ মানে গড়া একদম মানুহে উঠাই একদম মানুহে কঢ়িয়াই লৈছে বা কাটি লৈছে গছ গছনি কাটি লৈছে ইয়াত গাঁৱৰ এইটো ব্ৰহ্মপুত্ৰ নাছিলে এইটো এইটো নাছিলে ব্ৰহ্মপুত্ৰ
ইন মাজুলি 50 or so missing villages are now underwater
বেৰ গৰ বেৰ কৰ আছে কৰ নাই দব দব বাগিছো আৰু
দা মিসিং কমিউনিটি
পকা গৈ বিলাক টিং বিলাক চপা বাগিছা গিন লৈ গৈছো গিয়া নিব পৰাটো নিছোঁ নিব নোৱাৰাতো থাকি গ'ল আৰু খেতি এই খেতি বাতি চব এৰালে তাৰপিছত এই ঘৰ ঘৰণি উনি পেলাই ৰাতিৰ ওপৰলৈ নাই ঘৰ ঘৰণি উনি ওচৰ পালেগৈ যেন ঘৰা খনীয়া হৈ পেলাই
আমি খেতি কৰিলে পথাৰলৈ গ'লে আমি পইচা পাতি ইনকাম কৰিব পাৰিছিলোঁ চলিব পাৰিছিলোঁ তাত কোনো অসুবিধা নাছিল কিন্তু তেতিয়া খেতি হৈছিল
last one they often, because the flood, they cannot cultivate, and then how do they survive? They wonder, how do they do living? So question has come up to the Assam government that it is institutional.
Taman mati, amar jibla potar mati, jibla bali purise kiba hase tar ami kheti bati koribon ra hase.
Kintu majuri karone etiao bor mane bipodjonok. Kotike ami etu mane khub dukhi hoise majuri karone.
কারণ মাজুলি শেষ হয়ে যাব বলে আমার কোনো ভয় নাই বলে ভাবো, কারণ হয়তো আমি আশা করছো মাজুলি এতিয়া সরকারিভাবেও যথেষ্টখিনি, আমাৰ ভাৰত চৰকাৰে বা অসম চৰকাৰে যথেষ্টখিনি তাৰ ব্যৱস্থা লৈছে।
এইটো কোন দিছে, এই কোন, এইটো তিখাৰাৰে বনাইছে, জেং দিয়াবিলাক বাঢ়ে হৈছে, এই গুজ দিয়াবিলাক বেয়া হৈছে।
How much longer can these fragile defences hold out against the powerful river? 32 monasteries have been gradually swept away by the waves. A third of the surface of the island has disappeared in 50 years, taking with it a part of the heritage of Assam, and thus of India. These people are threatened with impending catastrophe, and like animals who smell the storm coming, they know it. But in India, anything is possible. Even the impossible. So they keep hoping.
Everything is possible in India. Even the impossible is possible.
They've asked me to tell you about them. They hope that UNESCO, engineers and public funding will do whatever is needed to save Majuli.
UNESCO will help.
Government and while they wait, they've assured me that they'll keep on dancing.
Krishna dance of the Kadamba Mule.
Anande Govinde.
Anande Govinde.
Vrindabane. Rupe bhubana bhule rohiya kadambar mule
rohiya kadambar mule. So there is always a desire, and there is a continuous philosophy, whatever the scriptures tell us, etc., that Majuli will survive, as Satradhikar was saying. When I recently met the chief minister, I was given an award by Madhodev Award for my work. I did ask him. He said that if we lose Majuli and if we lose the Sattriya culture, then we are not Assamese. And somehow all efforts will be made in order to keep them alive. The tradition, would we keep them alive? I did ask him one question. When they established one Shankardev Kalakshetra, beautiful Kalakshetra has been built in Guwahati. I said, would government provide some grants so that people can come and learn? Because suppose you have to go and learn Sattriya dance, you want to learn it in Assam under a great guru, then where would you stay there? What about the musicians? I used to tell the people there who say about Sattriya, Hatriya dance, I said it has to have something what we call Karnapriya, Karnamadhur. It's not that it's not Karnamadhur, it's very moving. Today, a few days ago, I met Popon, the great vocalist. He's a very popular singer, Popon. And he sings wonderful, Bargit. I said, what I saw 50 years ago, when Guru Keluchan Mahapatra, Bhuvanas Mishra, they are creating Pallavis, Shankara Pranam Pallavi, Arabi Pallavi. Even today, those who are Odissi dancers would know, when these Pallavis are sung, you are thrilled. So somewhere an element of the music, without sacrificing the original quality of Assamese music, if it's brought out, Hatriya will take it up. Today, there is not a single dancer, girl, who doesn't know Hatriya in Assam. They continuously perform. It has gone beyond the borders of India. There are two girls, Mrudusmita and Prerana Bhuya, in Washington, D.C., where they are teaching Hatriya. There are people now in London. Menaka Pepura's daughter is there. They are teaching Hatriya. So Hatriya has moved, including the point that Bhavananda Barbayan, whom we saw, he brought Japanese people, and then last time when I was in, recently in Assam, they said, Are Tame to Gujarati cho, Gujubhai. The Assam na Gujarati mandale Ram Lila Ram natak bajvelo hatu. So it's possible that they go beyond Assam border because they want to bring it on the all over the world. I do believe that what we have in terms of the great legacy in terms of the dance which has come, of course, it was in 2000 that the Sattriya became very classical. Sangeet Natak Academy gave the recognition, and from then on, every year on the 15th of November, they call it Nritya Parva, and dance is being performed regularly for 4 or 5 days, etc. But somewhere it has to happen in all India level. Indira Gandhi National Center in Delhi recently invited the great Guru Jatin Goswami, and he came and did a wonderful workshop. I think we had earlier done also a workshop over here, and there's a proposal that if the dancers are interested, Pratisha Suresh is here, one of the Sattriya dancers. She would like to conduct the workshop. What she had done, she invited Jhelam Paranjape, she invited Daksha Mashruwala, one Bharatnatyam dancer, Sandhya Puricha. But they took the Assami song and perform in Bharatnatyam, Assami song perform in Odissi, Assami perform in other language, but not the Sattriya. So this dancer did perform Sattriya. I'm sure that the beauty of Sattriya dance, which is being today shown by Anvesha Mohan, Mirnanda Bar Thakur, Lima Das and all, it will definitely move to the world. Centers like National Center Performing Arts done a great service. I must say that in 1972-73, when I began to bring the gurus over here, Popul Jaikar had come, Hema Malini had come, and the dancers wanted to know about its form, etc. With the advantage that we have about a film like this, to people who saw the film will remember how Sattriya has survived as a cultural form, how it is being survived. I'm sure that more such efforts are being made, the borders will be vanished. It will not remain limited only to Assam. It will be shared by everybody. If there are any questions, I'll be willing to answer one or two. Otherwise, I want to thank you everyone who came this early morning and spent time with us watching Sattriya film, etc. In particular, where is my dear friend Swapna? Swapna Kalpaji. Inko bula lo.
Backstage.
I want to say something nice about her. When I met her, I did come 4 or 5 years ago. Then I said, let's do something called dance separation courses. She was very keen. And then it worked out like this way for the 50 years that she managed to have 8 classical dance forms. Not only that, very inclusive, so Parker, Latin dance and all.
Yeah, it's a folk.
So folk dance also. So thank you so much. I feel so grateful to it because it brings very happy memories for me. From this very stage, I have worked many times, spoken about the dance and spoken about the dance course, making it once again a dream come true. Thank you so much. Namaskar. Thank you, sir. Namaskar.
Questions?
Or we can meet in the foyer and we can ask. But any question, I'll definitely happy to answer. Should come from the young dancers who have come, who are not performing Hatriya.
I think one of them, she had a question, no? Would you like to ask?
Yeah. Say it loudly, yeah. What's your name? Yeah. What has happened now, yeah, Sattriya, like all other classical dance forms, it has a busy position. Purush Pak, Prakriti Pak, body band, Hasta, there is a text called Hasta Lakshan Deepika. And then it lose the Shubhankar Hasta Muktavali. There are hand gestures like, you know, Pataka Hasta, Pataka Tripataka, and then the Viniyogas are there. Natyarambe Varibhai. Similarly, there are many, many histories are given. If you want to say king, the king is a chhatra. So this chhatra and then with Shikhar, one mudra. Suchi Hasta becomes king. So when I was studying and comparing from Abhinay Darpan and also Nandikeshwaras and all, I found out that it's a tremendous classical form. There are footsteps also cross, Swastik Pad, etc., the Dashavatar and all. I do believe that the more presentations are done here by outside dancers or people who are coming from Assam, like Anvesha Mohant, Mirnanda Bar Thakur, this one Lima Das, who became very famous now, having acted in an Assamese film called Amish. And she does wonderful dancing. Chef, this Sharodaya Sekia, Indira P.P. Bora, her daughter who has gone away to London, they are the artists who are making dance popular. What happened earlier in 1950s when Guru Rasheshwar Sekia they allow the monk to marry. Once he marry with the grihastha ashram, you have to go out of the ashram and then you go to Guwahati and you can start your school. So Rasir Shaikya decided that when he comes out of the ashrama, he will train his own daughters, Ranjumani and Injumani. Both of them were trained dance. There was Sharudhi Shaikya, Indira Pepi Bora, and these are the pioneer women who began to perform in public. And the inhibitions went away, that only the male dancers would play the female role, it went away. So female began to take the female role and began to perform. Now, as we all know, in Bharatanatyam, there is Margam, Alaripu, Jatiswar, Shabda, Varna, Pad, Shlok, Tillana, and all. Similarly, they decided that from the dance dramas, like Ram Vijay Natak, as you saw the dance dramas were being performed, or the Ras Leela performed, they began to take the extracts of it and began to form as a solo item. Now, as you know how beautiful the costumes are there, even this Satra, Hatriya, these beautiful designs are there. So the young girls have designed Varna food costumes for their solo dance, etc. And they perform both pure dance as well as Abhinay dance. So pure dance are what they call Chali. They bolla with that, funnily they call it Sali, but it becomes Chali. So various Chalis are there. Now there are pure dance items are also there, and there are also Abhinay items are there. So Abhinay items were boundless because of the Kirtan Ghosha of Guru Shankardev and Madhav Dev. The songs are absolutely marvelous songs. And one Anvesha Mahant has taken it up upon herself to take those songs in way of performing like what you do in Abhinay. Now Abhinay is not only the Abhinay part of the Sa, but also they can have the Vachika Abhinay. And they bring Vachika Abhinay to presentation. So from the element of the dance dramas, which are called Ankiya Bhavana and Ankiya Nat, they've taken the puja elements of this and brought into a solo dance form. Like what happened in, say, Kuchipudi. Kuchipudi was a dance drama. And then you are see this evening you are going to see Shantarati, who will be presenting from traditional how the solo dance form came. So there is a tradition about it that if the dance tradition is there, from there how do you make it more relevant? How do you make it more contemporary? How do you make it more ko bhi achha lage, kaano ko bhi sunne achha lage, and also maintain the traditional core. Assamese jo element hai usko todna nahi hai, usko samal ke rakhna hai, and that is the only way that this dance solo dance form will become more and more popular. It happens, so you know, I live in Delhi, so we are in capital, and sometimes I joke that if you live in capital, it's capital punishment. But there is also an advantage in Delhi that everything comes to Delhi. So dance dramas are performed in Delhi, they come and perform the ICCR, even ICCR nowadays send the Sattriya dancers abroad, and then element of popularity has come. I'm sure that with the passage of time, with wonderful initiative that Swapna has taken, we'll have a performance also of Sattriya dancers. We often have performance of solo dance also. She's invited a number of dancers, Anvesha Mahant, and a number of people have come over here. Anita Sharma, yes. Darshana wants to get an observation that when she went and visited Majuli Island, she saw the young monks. And as we saw in the film, the training is given. And these are called Mati Akhada. And it is similar to the Gotipua of Orissa. In Orissa, the Gotipua boys, they play the female role. And like Gotipua, they also dance. And they do the physical exercises, which are acrobatic and also full of vyayam. So they will take the positions of the turning backwards, etc., and make their body very pliable. So there is what she said is very true. When Shankardev had gone actually to Jagannath Puri, and during his travel for 12 years, he was born in 1449, and he lived for 110 years. So when he traveled to Jagannath Puri, he had seen these Gotipua dancers. He had seen the Maharis Devadasi also. So there is a tradition of Devdhani Nritya in Assam, where the Devdasi Nritya was being done. It was almost extinct, but recently some 20 people have taken over to revive the traditional dance, which is a Devdasi dance of Assam, Devi Nritya, etc. So partly, I do believe that it happened so that it was not accessible. Even when Sangeet Natak Academy took interest, it was in 1958. We are in 2019 now, 2020 almost. Number of years have gone. So the accessibility part was difficult about Assam, and therefore, though Manipur became very popular, Assam had not become that popular. Assam had not had that dynamic push, etc. Even today, when you meet some Assamis, they say, lahe lahe, aram se karega, koi jaldi nahi hai. But now, the young dancers have woken up very well. The young light dancers like Anvesha Mahant, Anita Sharma, Mirinda Bhatt Thakur, they're doing wonderful work, and they want to come and perform. I also often say that everything we cannot expect National Center for the Performing Arts to do. There are other institutions in the city. Other, you know, festivals are there where this dance could be seen. If this film has made you curious about watching the dance, etc., whenever Swapna organizes here of Sattriya dance, please make it a point to come. And many answers will be given to them. Namaskar. Thank you.